shoot. So what is it? What do you call making America great again? Shit, look. Is that fences around? All these fences around the houses? Making America great? Is that black folks entering through the back again? White folks entering through the front and feeling privileged? Is that what making America great? No, this is not a racist thing. This is just me talking about what I see. You know, people get the idea that when white folks are moving into the neighborhood, that means the neighborhood's getting better. Well, here's the neighborhood, part of it. I'm looking at every house then become a fortress. You know, all you got to do, look at these houses. All you got to do is throw some barbed wire on top of these fences and you got a fortress, or you encased in your own prison, one or the other. I guess that shows that we're getting ready for something in our society that we ain't never been ready for. Maybe war, who knows? You know, the atmosphere. Just a matter of time for the homeless people, and people that are homeless, it's just a matter of time for they realize that they ain't got nothing and ain't got nothing to lose and decide they want to rise up. Then we really gonna have a problem. You know, I say with all this excess money just being thrown around here and there by our government and by some individuals and entities, that we need to start putting it into housing people in this country that's so wealthy and got so much capital and so much money, that we need to start doing something for these people that live out here under these freeways and in these homeless encampments, before they start realizing that they ain't got nothing to lose and turn on you. You better think about that. So if I were you, I'd be nice to a homeless person, because a homeless person ain't got no home. They ain't got no support system. Don't want it, maybe. But I'll tell you one thing I do know about them is that after a while, just like anybody, survival thing, they're going to start realizing they ain't got nothing to lose. Then what? Because this making America great again, I don't understand that saying, because we just came out of the civil rights movement and that kind of really ended in like the early 70s, maybe 73. So you figure from 74, you figure from 1974, you figure from 1974 up to now, when exactly was America great for black people? I'm just trying to figure it out. Because not long before the civil rights movement, we was dealing with Jim Crow and all that. So America being great again, what does that mean for black people? You know, when someone white in power, in a position of power, says that we want to make America great again, that doesn't always bode well for black people. When they had the LA riots, white people were talking about taking their cities back. We're taking our cities back. So they have aggressively and almost violently taken their cities back. They done moved all in. They pretty much priced poor black people and poor people, namely black people, priced them out of Oakland. So I guess that's making America great. And when they talk about making America great, does that include people that look like me? I'm very concerned. Because what it seems like they're doing is bringing back Jim Crow without the whites only and the black enter in the back signs. So they're configuring our society in such a way that you have the whites only signs invisible. They're invisible now. Blacks go around to the back, or blacks are not allowed in this establishment, blah, da, 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 da. Those are invisible signs, but they're there. And, you know, it's just a situation. Nobody wants to talk about this big giant elephant in the room. Nobody, you know, because unfortunately for black folks, we don't own any businesses, but a lot of us got jobs and we're happy with our jobs. Well, those jobs that you work at, black people, they are companies that are usually owned by white people, and they could merge with somebody else, decide to move, decide to close, decide to merge with somebody, change their name, decide to fire you, and then you ain't got a job. So don't sit there thinking that you're sitting pretty because you got some job that's paying you $20 an hour and you're able to go to school, put your kids through school, buy all this material stuff. Well, they want you to have a job because we're the biggest consumers. So as soon as we get some money, we running off to buy white name brand products. So they want you to have a job now, you know, but they want you to have just enough to spend your money with them, because we have shown them a pattern of blowing our money on their products, on their name brands, you know. I mean, that's like spending the money at such and such plantation, because that's where a lot of these established organizations and corporations stem from. They stem from the money that they made during slavery times, where black people were disenfranchised and enslaved and owned. So, you know, no sooner we were freed out of bondage, the bondage of slavery, we felt to feel free and to feel white and arrived, we got to have the latest and the greatest name brands. I got a job. I see people act silly because they got a job. Or they act, I'm not like the others because they got a job. Well, guess what? Your job is not secure. Anybody out there that think their job is secure, you better think again, because it's not. In fact, the way corporate America is operating now, you know, you got to go back to school and get trained for these new positions. Whatever position you got, after a while, they're going to automate it, and you're going to have to go back to school to learn how to get the automation of America and the work industry. So think about that. You better get to saving your money and pooling your money together and owning some businesses, or buying some land, or just coming together as the Chinese and as the Indians have, and all these other racial groups who are moving into your neighborhood, buying up everything and treating you the same way the white people do. They're not your friends. Not to say don't like them or what, but they're going with the status quo. And if status quo says being different to the black man, then that's what they're gonna do, because there's an invisible law out here. Look out for the niggas. You know, don't partner up with them. Don't do this. Don't do that. I once had a Chinese man tell me that where he come from, the region that he comes from in China, black people are cursed people. So think about that. When people come over here from other countries, what are they coming over here with? What kind of thinking are they coming over here with? They already have a train of thought, not to mention what they're briefed on in that secret room at the airport, or the secret room down at the ports, at the piers. Well, however they're coming into the country, trust me, they go into another room and get briefed on this is America, and this is the pitfalls, and this is what you should watch out for, and don't do this, and don't do that, and don't do that, and don't do this. So anyway, it's just something to look, you know, to keep an eye on. stay conscious of. Because for America to be great again means that I have to take a step. People that look like me have to take a step back and a step down. So whatever you thriving for in America, just remember that there's some folks out here that wants America to be back to what it was. They want it to be back to Jim Crow. They want it to be back to you being a black people and minorities being second class and third class citizens, if that's what they want. They don't even, you're not even a citizen here. You're just second and third class. You know, you are, a lot of you are taxpayers. A lot of us are taxpayers and all this, and we have this certain pride we'd like to have about our country. But you know, we sit up and say it's our country all day, but nobody really wants to share this with us, not the black people, you know. Then you got a lot of black folks out here that just is not getting the gist of it. But here I am walking down the street, you know, in the city of Oakland. You know, there's this big building right here. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Yeah, there's this big building right here, all this commercial. See, they finna put a lot of commercial. That's Emeryville, and that end down there is downtown Oakland. So they trying to put a strip of commercial and all this stuff through here. And if you go down to City Hall, we're not a part of it. You have some upper echelon Negroes that think that they have a stake here. You don't have a stake here. You got to take it. You got to aggressively take what you want. Like they're aggressively coming in your neighborhood and taking what they want and putting you and your family and your children and your grandparents out on the street. And then say, oh, they on dope. They need to be there. There ain't no jobs. There's plenty jobs out here. They want you to have a job so that you can get your money and spend it with them and be the number one consumer in America and hold that position down like we've been doing. So, you know, it's time to wake up. It's time to wise up and get it together. Because we are being eliminated out of this society. I don't give a damn if Facebook like it or not. Or whatever, because, you know, this anti, I call it anti-social media, is trying to control what you say with all this freedom of speech and all that. But you can't say what you want to say on Facebook because somebody always complaining. Well, I don't give a fuck. I really don't. I'm going to say what I have to say because it might reach some of the right ears. And it might incite some people to get up and make a stand. Because we need soldiers out here. We need real soldiers. We don't need people that finna run down here and do a bunch of marches and stuff. That shit is old. You gotta have when you march, anything you wanna have in any society, you gotta have an army behind you. Not no marching. Because when you get out here and march, guess what? They bring out their army against you. So all that peaceful marching and stuff, that's for the birds. Anybody to say that it ain't, they need to check their history books and see that don't work. It worked with Martin Luther King, and they always want to throw that in your face. Oh, Dr. Martin Luther King, all these people that was telling nigger go home, nigger get out of here, nigger I don't want you in my school, I don't want you in my restaurant, I don't want you in my store. Those very same people that was saying those things back in the 50s and the 60s and the 40s are now today, 2017, are telling trying to convince everybody, I march with Dr. Martin Luther King. That's what they say. I march with Dr. Martin Luther King. No, you didn't march with no Dr. Martin Luther King. You was at the march. You was on the sideline saying, nigga, go home. But you did not march with Dr. Martin Luther King. You know, just this big influx of white people who's saying that they march with Dr. Martin Luther King. If that was the case, we would not have what's going on, this gentrification in Oakland. It's very ruthless, it's bloodthirsty. And I just think people need to really start taking a look at it. We so concerned about, oh, I don't want to be dubbed a racist. Oh, I don't want to hate white people. I'm not telling you to hate white people. I'm telling you to, if you want to make America great, then have a stake in it. Start taking what's yours like they're taking what's theirs. Have to start making a stand for it. Because this is all stolen from the Indians. So, you know, it's time to make a stand and get your piece of this America that you have coming. You have this coming. So, I mean, you could keep on working your job every day and probably work 10, 15 years, get fired. Then they don't want you to come up to the job. They finna call the police on you if you come up to the job. You know, and everybody's working for, oh, this retirement. Well, that's not promised to you no more. Because these companies don't want to pay the retirement no more. The insurance don't even want to pay you what you got coming after you done paid so much into them. But when you get close to almost retiring, they're sure to try to lay you off or fire you so they can give you less money. And if the companies merge, they can find a way to not give you nothing at all for all your years of service. So think about that. And see that sign right there? It's probably backwards to you, but it says no trespassing. See that? It's backwards, but it says no trespassing. They can put signs up like that, but what they really want to put up is no niggas. Oakland is known for, that's like New Orleans being known for Mardi Gras and Carnival and all that stuff. Now when you see Mardi Gras in New Orleans, it's almost half white dominated, believe it or not, when it was something that was founded and started by the slaves. Okay, New Orleans jazz. We are being phased out violently, aggressively, you know. And I'm just appealing to the men because women are always getting stuff handed to them on a platter. So they're not warriors, you know. They will bend and bow with any, and they'll go with the flow of the stream. But men out there have to start taking the stand. What's yours? What do you want to be yours? You know, what kind of stand you gonna take? Because they're not only taking everything from us, they're decimating our families, denying us of industry, and any other kind of thing, just disenfranchising us at every turn. You know, and you know, a lot of people know that I do the Scene Festival. I've been producing and promoting the Scene Festival with my own money for many years, now going on 22 years. And to be real honest, if I were a white man, I'd be living off that Scene Festival. I'd be making big money. But because I'm a black man and coming from where I come from, a lot of corporations, I'm a risk. A lot of corporations don't want to mess with me. You know, I'm seen as a risk. Anytime a black man wants to do so, I don't care how much college you got, like I have plenty college, and I'm still seen, viewed as a risk. And this is all by design. You know, the country was founded on racism. The country was founded on slavery. What makes you think this leopard is going to change its spots? What makes you think that? Who out there believes this, make America great? To make America great means to enslave me again. To make America great means to make me a second class and third class citizen again. That's what it means. It does not mean a comeuppance for black people. It does not mean that. Get that in your head, my black people. I don't care who here. You don't like it? You don't got to chime in. I don't care. You know, because it's about me and my family of people that look like me. You know, somebody wants to put the sign back up and tell me to enter in through the back or to pick up whatever I need from the side, or that I'm not allowed in this building or that building or this establishment or that establishment. You know, see the writing on the wall. You know, you got people that was not happy with black people integrating. There's people that still not happy with black people being free and just being regular citizens. They still want it to be the way it was. That's why you have these cries of making America great again. That's another way of saying, let's bump niggas back where they belong. Let's bump the Chinese back where they belong. Let's bump the Mexicans back where they belong. And give white people all this privilege and all this freedom and pride. Okay? And with that, America will be great again. Because everybody will be back in their place. So, if that's what you think of America being great again, you better think again. Because this is serious. I could go right now and show you hundreds of people living under a bridge. Hundreds of people living under freeways. That's not where people are supposed to live. Not with all these hundreds of billions. Now they don't even talk millions no more. They talk billions. They talk trillions. Now, all these trillions and people that look like me are living under the freeway and got you black people convinced that all those people on drugs because you got a little job and your ways and means of life is okay now, so you want to downplay everybody else. That's not the case. Yeah, you got some people there that been living out there under the freeway and in them tent cities for so long to the point that they done kind of got used to it and they don't want to do nothing better. But there is a percentage of those people who are elderly, who has a lot of mental illness, who are sick, and they just don't know where to turn because now we live in a society where insurance is forced on you. You got to have this credit report and that credit report. And when it's your enemies that's determining how good your credit is, then your credit is never good. When your enemies are determining how good your credit score is. Think about that. You foolish ones that with your jobs and stuff. If you ain't owning it, my dad used to say to me, son, if you don't own it, it ain't yours. So get that in your head. If you don't own it, it ain't yours. So the point of that is to start buying and start owning, pooling your money together. You know, yeah, the black Muslims were saying that for so long, and we couldn't get past them being black Muslims. We didn't even want to hear what they wanted to say because these white-ran black Negro churches, you know, they didn't want to hear what the Muslims had to say. When the black man started talking, oh, you militant. I'm not militant because I want what the next person have. I want what any human being should have. I'm militant for speaking up. I'm racist for speaking my mind. I'm racist for noticing racism. Let's get it together. Tyrone Ingram is far from being a racist. You know, some of my best friends are white. I know you heard that before. But anyway, you know, I don't want to deviate. But what this is all about is America being great again. You know, what part do you play in America being great? Ask yourself that. What part? What does America being great again, what does that have to do with you as a black person? What does that have to do with you as a Chinese person? What does it have to do with you as a Latino? What does it have to do with you, America being great? Because at the time that they're talking about when America was being great, everybody that is considered a minority today was bumped back, way back. In fact, they didn't even want you to have a voice. And when that was happening, America was great. So anyway, that's just food for thought. You know, America being great again means oppression for you. You know, who knows? In the next couple of months, they might come up with something that a lot of people who are working right now might lose their jobs. Then you'll feel the brunt of what's really going on. You know, because these jobs out here, they don't just want your neighborhoods, they want your jobs. CPS is taking your kids, they want your kids. They want your soul. So think about that. They want your soul. Anyway, I said enough. So play your part and do your part about making America great again. You better make America great again for you. Because those that's talking about making America great, they're talking about making America great for them and themselves. So you're not included. America being great again means you bumped back down to nothing. So you got your little job, you better save your little money, but watch where you save that money. Because when America was great, a black man couldn't save no money because they, at every turn, they found a way to steal his money even out of his bank account. That's why black people kept their money in, buried in the yard and in mattresses. But you can't bury it in the yard no more because you don't own, most of us don't own a house or land that we could bury anything. You know, those people that got cars, that they want, they like cars and they want to fix the car up and pass the car on down to the son. Well, those days are over because the police take your car, especially if you're black. You know, so there's no projected legacy for you and me. It's just not, unless you are part of the status quo and doing something like you're a celebrity. You have to damn near become a celebrity to be a normal black person in America. If you're not a celebrity, then they don't recognize you. Only thing they recognize is when you get paid and you ready and set to run out here and spend your money with all these top corporations on the latest and the greatest. So stop being a fool and spending all your money on needless things and start thinking about investments into real capital. Put real capital into some investments and start owning some things. You know, buy an island. Pull your money together. You know, I go over here and I talk to these people in Tent City and I reach a few that I tell them to go down, you're a refugee. Go down and apply for refugee status if you're homeless and you're living in a tent. Apply for refugee status because you don't have to worry about credit checks anymore. You're going to get one big lump sum of money once you get to have that refugee status. You know, you get the same qualities that's due a refugee that's coming from another country. You are qualified for that same, for all those same, you know, prizes, as I'll call it. Anyway, I said enough. You know, you could gist of what I'm talking about. You know, I mean, I say this and I say that, but I say this heartfelt and I say it real. You know, look around your neighborhoods before you start talking about how good you doing as an individual. Yeah, you're doing probably good as an individual, but look around your neighborhood or go a few blocks outside your neighborhood and see that things ain't really changed. You maybe change your environment, but, you know, it's really hard to change who you are, what you are. You could change who you are, your personality and whatnot, and your status in this society, but you can't change what you are, black people. And the people that's out here, your enemies who are still running things, they want you gone. They either gonna lock you up, pit you against your brother, or just flat out take what you got. So there's your options. That makes America great again. So you figure it out. You want to be a part of America's greatness? You better get out here and start aggressively taking what's yours too. Because these people want to take their cities back. And if you don't believe me, look at Richmond, look at East Palo Alto, look at Oakland, and look at all the formerly black communities of San Francisco. Check yourself before you start thinking things are getting great. Yeah, they might be getting great for the next person. They're not getting great for us. You know, here we are with all this modern technology out here. And we're under freeways in tents. We're a subculture, people. You know, and people, I'm not under no freeway. I ain't in no tent. Yeah, but those people in the tent under the freeway, they go to them just like they go to that foolish person when they doing the interview in the news. They go over there to that tent city, and that represents you as a black person, whether you wanted to or not. But anyway. You can say, oh, yeah, I'm just catting off. But you think about that. Next time you watch the news, look how you're depicted in the news. It's the same way, except now they can always flash over there to some homeless person and make black people everywhere in America look destitute and unassuming and you know, and just worthless. I mean, I know you got some worth. I know I got some worth. You know, but look at the people around you that look like you. If they're suffering, then you in so many ways are also suffering. So anyway, just keep that in mind. think about your part in making America great, and what that means to you, what that means to us as a people. You know, like I said, all them people, all these marches, they mean nothing. You know, it's aggressive action is what you need to take, not marches. Need to put our heads together and come up with a new way and a new scheme and a new way to do battle. Because marching is not it. That Black Lives Matter, that's garbage. That's not even black people. You know, it don't mean nothing. Why would anybody even put that on the agenda, that black lives, my life matters since I was born. My life matters. My life matters to God. I don't care if my life matters to these white folks out here. I really don't, you know. So anyway, make America great again, but make it great for you. All right. Bless up. I'm gone. See ya.